That's what it's all about, right? Making true democracy harder. Adding hoops to jump through, hurdles to leap, and walls to climb. At the top, I talked about the anti-democratic obstacles baked in at the federal level. This discussion highlights the fact that Hoosiers have had even more roadblocks placed in front of us. Indiana was the first state to introduce voter ID requirements in response to the non-existent problem of voter fraud, and now we have the worst turnout in the country. Still, Republicans in Indianapolis continue making it even harder to vote. So, more difficult to run for office, more difficult to vote in elections, no ballot initiatives, no referendums, no direct democracy, and a nearly impossible to amend state constitution. So, what this means is that even if Hoosiers can sweep Jennifer McCormick into the governor's office and elect a strong crop of new legislators to the state house, Democrats cannot flip the state Senate this year. Assuming continued Republican intransigence, we cannot even begin the amendment process until at least 2027, pass an amendment opening the Constitution up to ballot initiatives by the people until 2029, and both will likely take much longer. I say this not to discourage us, not that the Indiana left can get more discouraged than we have been recently, but to rouse all of us to do our part. The mechanisms for change do exist, and if we each incorporate saving democracy into our everyday lives, we can reach that summit. And furthermore, there might be a shortcut. If Americans deliver Kamala Harris to the White House with a cooperative House and Senate, Democrats are promising to pass the Freedom to Vote Act, the John Lewis Voting Rights Act, and a host of reforms meant to remove many of those hurdles to democracy. Voter suppression, partisan sabotage, gerrymandering, and unlimited dark money. And maybe with those obstacles out of the way, with robust participation in professionally run elections conducted in fairly drawn districts, where policy and principles matter more than fundraising and ad spending, Indiana can have a state government that reflects the real, progressive Hoosier values that we've held all along.